Merle, in 2000, when you decided to go with waterbeds, why? They were new, unheard of?
Well, I knew what I had in the old barn. It had loose rubber that was under a canvas, and it had gotten packed down and hard, and we had refilled a time or two, and I knew I wanted something better, something to go to. I was thinking I'd probably go with a mattress, something very similar, but I was looking at the options. I heard about waterbeds, and I guess the one of the things that caused me to do it about as much as anything was somehow I found out about a study that the University of Georgia was doing when I think they had 10 or so different surfaces for cows to be on. And I called down there and talked with the professor involved, and he sent me a study that came out of Europe. And there was that European study. I'm thinking about 15 different surfaces, including bare concrete and straw on concrete. About 4 or 5 of those surfaces were European and not available here. And those seemed to rate the highest. The rest of the, it seemed like the surfaces were in 3 distinct groups: the European group, the middle group, and the bottom group. The middle group had waterbeds in it, and they made this comment concerning them, something to the extent that while waterbeds didn't score or didn't show maybe the greatest, it was noted that after, as the cows were in amongst them, and the longer time they were there, they were using the waterbeds more versus the first week. So they would, apparently they were, most stalls they went to on a regular basis initially, but the waterbeds they ignored initially, and then as time went on, they got to using them more and more. Mm-hmm. And that, and as I recall, waterbeds was one of the top surfaces in the middle group. Mm-hmm. And I concluded that, well, if they were using them more and more as the study progressed, and they're one of the top ones in that group there, well, it's probably a good surface, a good mm-hmm. deal.
And when you talked before, you had mentioned that you considered sand when you were building this new barn. Why not sand?
Why not sand? I did not like the idea of sand getting into this, that, and everything, and bearings and whatnot all else. And I didn't like the idea of sand filling up a manure pit. Mm-hmm. I think, I'm not saying sand isn't good. Mm-hmm. I think it is a good bed, but it does take, in my mind, more maintenance. Mm-hmm. More time consuming, and I'm glad I didn't go that route from the standpoint of some of that aspect.
Do you think your cows have suffered health-wise or production-wise?
If anything, I think if they've suffered, it has to do with the slippery concrete in the alleys. Yeah. I can believe sand might help prevent as much slippiness there. Mm-hmm. But that's the only area that I feel that they've suffered. Knowing how things get done around here sometimes, why, I think overall it's been a plus not to have sand, because I can believe the bedding wouldn't get kept after sometimes.
Mm. Thanks. Okay.